Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, says that the first successful launch of a Starship into orbit will probably happen between 1 and 12 months from now. This short tweet says a lot about the near future of the next generation rocket program. The famously optimistic CEO's latest estimate for the Starship schedule is unusually cautious, vague, and open-ended, but it does set some reasonable expectations for how likely success is. Welcome to Techmo. In today's video, we will be taking a look at the latest information regarding SpaceX's first orbital Starship launches. A couple of days ago, SpaceX brought their massive Super Heavy Booster 7 back to the launch pad for another attempt. Reports indicate that the Booster 7 prototype was moved to the orbital launch pad at Starbase during the night of Friday, August 5th, in order to undergo testing there. And on August the 8th, SpaceX began the testing of both Booster 7 and Ship 24 simultaneously. On Saturday, August the 6th, Elon Musk tweeted from Starbase about the arrival of Booster 7 while he was there. He uploaded a total of two pictures. The first one depicts B7 in the process of traveling to the launch pad. He tagged the tweet with, "A short while ago, Elon Musk discussed his perspectives and anticipations regarding the initial launch of Starship Orbital. He stated in his writing that a successful orbital flight is probably between 1 and 12 months from now. Therefore, it is quite plausible that SpaceX is working hard and quickly as well in order to get Booster 7 and its Starship upper stage spacecraft ready for the program's first ever orbital test flight, which the company plans to launch within the next few months. Booster 7 is a rocket that will be used by SpaceX. The current objective for SpaceX is to get Starship into orbit as quickly as possible, preferably within a month and no later than a year. The launch is scheduled to take place by September of 2022, according to the primary forecast. In order for SpaceX teams to achieve this objective, comprehensive testing and verification of both the ship and the Super Heavy will need to take place during the month of August. If we go with the second expectation, then we will have to postpone the launch of the first Starship into orbit by 1 year. However, if the SpaceX teams decide to forego using Booster 7 for the launch and instead use Booster 8, then it is still possible that they can go for launch within 4 to 6 months. With the objective of completing testing within 1 month in mind, SpaceX teams have begun testing of both Ship 24 and Booster 7. On August the 8th, they performed two spin prime tests on Ship 24, which were followed by massive venting. They also performed two spin prime tests on Super Heavy Booster 7, which were followed by depressurization of the booster. Additionally, on August 9th, they conducted testing of the dual static fires on both Ship 24 and Booster 7. The goals of the examination have not yet been validated in an official capacity. Musk did not elaborate on what he considers to be a successful definition for the Starship orbital launch. According to some sources, if success is defined as simply reaching orbit or deploying a few satellites of the next generation of Starlink into orbit, then it is plausible that Starship will be able to carry it out. However, if a Super Heavy Booster catch and Starship surviving its first orbital re-entry are both required for success, then the chances of success are extremely low up until this point. The following update will discuss Northrop Grumman's purchase of 3 launches for their Cygnus spacecraft from SpaceX. Northrop Grumman recently signed a launch contract with SpaceX to send 3 Cygnus cargo missions to the International Space Station. These missions are scheduled to take place in the near future. According to other sources, Northrop Grumman was awarded this contract with SpaceX at the same time that they were working with Firefly Aerospace to develop an improved version of their workhorse Antares rocket. An official from Northrop Grumman named Ellen Klicka made the following statement regarding the launch contract that her company had entered into with SpaceX. The launches will take place in late 2023 and 2024 from the Kennedy Space Center, Florida, in support of the NG-20, 21, and 22 CRS missions. Northrop Grumman and Firefly Aerospace announced on August 8 that they will collaborate in the future to create a new first stage for Northrop's Antares launch vehicle, as well as a medium lift rocket. This announcement was made public. Earlier, the Yuzhnoye State Design Office and the Yuzhmash Machine Building plant in Ukraine were responsible for the production of the Antares first stage. This stage was powered by RD-181 engines manufactured by NPO Energomash in Russia for its initial stages. But in the context of the ongoing war between Russia and Ukraine, the production of uncharged rockets came to a standstill as supplies of those engines and equipment were cut off by Russia in response to Western sanctions that were imposed for its invasion of Ukraine. According to a report, Northrop had already finished the first stages of preparation for two additional Antares launches, the first of which is scheduled to take place in October. However, concurrently, they were also working on backup options in the event that either the first stage or the engines become unavailable as a result of the war situation, which is what led to the formation of the partnership with Firefly. Antares 330 is a name given to the improved model that Northrop and Firefly are working on at the moment. Sources claim that the first stage of the Antares 330 rocket will be powered by 7 Miranda engines that are currently being developed by Firefly. Both the stage's structure and its tanks will be made out of Firefly composites at this point. However, the upper stage of the Antares 330 rocket will be exactly the same as the upper stage of the existing Antares rocket. Antares 330 is planned to lift off from the launch pad that is currently in use at the Mid-Atlantic Regional Spaceport in Virginia. An earlier version of the Antares launcher was employed for the transportation of cargo to the International Space Station aboard Cygnus spacecraft. However, because Russia has stopped providing supplies, the launch of Antares is still in question in the midst of the conflict between Russia and Ukraine. Therefore, the launch of Antares 330 aboard Cygnus is scheduled. However, according to Scott Day of Northrop, it will take almost 2 years of time before Antares 330 is ready for space, which would be in the year 2024. As a result, Northrop signed 3 contracts with SpaceX for the launch of Falcon 9 rockets in order to bridge the gap between the launch of the previous Antares rocket and the launch of the first Antares 330 rocket. This enabled Northrop to continue sending Cygnus cargo missions to the space station. The payload capacity of the vehicle will reportedly significantly increase with the introduction of the Antares 330 rocket in comparison to the Antares rocket that is currently in operation. Day explained that the current Antares has the capability of delivering payload into the insertion orbit meant for space station missions, that is 8,100 kilograms. However, the upgrade Antares launcher will have the capability of delivering almost 10,500 kilograms to the same orbit. Both Northrop Grumman and Firefly Aerospace remain tight-lipped about the entirely new medium-lift launcher that they are developing together. Our discussion will come to a close today with an update on the Polaris Dawn mission being conducted by SpaceX. It is common knowledge that SpaceX conducted astronaut training in preparation for the Polaris Dawn mission. Since that time, SpaceX has made significant strides forward. During the month of May, teams from SpaceX trained the astronauts to participate in the first-ever commercial spacewalk. In addition, the most recent information suggests that the initial launch of the Polaris Dawn program will occur in December 2022 aboard a spacecraft manufactured by SpaceX and referred to as the Crew Dragon. During an air show, the person in charge of this program, Jared Isaacman, stated that we are looking at the end of the year right now, so likely December. Polaris Dawn has more to contribute in terms of its objectives. In addition to performing a spacewalk from the SpaceX Dragon capsule, as part of a private mission, the first launch aims to send the crew to an altitude of 1,400 kilometers and carry out trial communications with SpaceX's Starlink. Both of these objectives will be accomplished in the course of the mission. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you want to watch more videos like this one, then hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will always be notified.